Amidst the COVID-19 pandemic, the Department of Education issued Memorandum No. 27 Series of 2021 entitled Conduct of the K-12 Basic Education Program End of School Year Rights for School Year 2020-2021 in light of the COVID-19 public health emergency. Through this memorandum, the Department of Education announces the conduct of end of school year, EOSY, rights for kindergarten, grade 6, grade 10, and grade 12 learners who satisfactorily meet the curriculum requirements at the end of school year 2020-2021, including SY 2019-2020 learners who passed the portfolio assessment in the Alternative Learning System, ALS, elementary and junior high school levels, by virtue of the joint memorandum DMOUCI 2021-04, and the first batch of ALS senior high school, SHS, learners who meet the curriculum requirements. One of the unique reminders of the Department of Education in this school year's end of school year right is for school to make that parents' consent are required. To learn why this is required, please watch until the end of this video. The 2021 end of school year rights shall focus on the theme strengthening the quality of education amidst the COVID-19 pandemic to highlight that amid all the challenges the learners' rights to inclusive and quality education, and to safety from the health risks of COVID-19 must be given priority. With reference to Department Order No. 12 Series of 2021, also known as Amendment to Department Order No. 30 Series of 2020 or the Amendment to Department Order No. 7 Series of 2020 or the School Calendar and Activities for School Year 2020-2021, Quarter 4 shall end on July 10, 2021. Hence, within the week of July 12 to 16, 2021, schools and community learning centers, CLCs, are given the discretion to select the date for holding this year's end of school year rights. On the other hand, private schools may implement the schedule as reflected in their respective school calendars. However, given that public health and safety is deemed as topmost concern at this time, schools and CLCs shall abide by applicable guidelines and protocols set by the Department of Health, Interagency Task Force, IATF, and the Office of the President in light of the COVID-19 pandemic. Should the public health situation prevent the conduct of this year's EOSY rights within the said week, schools, in consultation with the Parents Teachers Association, PTA, may choose to reschedule or forego the activity. Private schools shall be guided by their approved school calendars or revised school calendar. To ensure the protection of the health and safety of learners, teachers, and personnel, as well as parents and other stakeholders, any face-to-face ceremony is not allowed. The virtual conduct of the EOSY rights may be an option for schools and CLCs, whenever feasible. Schools and CLCs may prepare a short program that will run in less than 2 hours to consider the internet connectivity that will be consumed. Only the completers, their parents or guardians, teachers, and school administrators will be present during the virtual rites. The schools have the discretion to broadcast live the virtual EOSY rites through appropriate social media platforms. The school shall secure the consent of the parents and learners before doing such broadcast. The multi-year implementing guidelines on the conduct of the K-12 Basic Education Program End of School Year rights enclosed in Department Order No. 2 Series of 2020 remains in force and in effect, except for the grant of academic awards, which shall be stipulated in a separate issuance on awards and recognition. Thank you for watching, and for more updates, don't forget to subscribe.